Welcome to Mo Health Media. My name is Guy Danhoff, and on episode 11, we have a very special broadcast as we are going to be joined with assistant principal of Bayless Junior High. I'll bring him in right now. That is Andrew Mertens. Andrew, how are you doing, my friend?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, we're really excited. It's always fun at Missouri Healthy Schools when we can bring on administrators, and we want to kind of start, you know, right away and get to it. And really the first thing that we want to kind of talk about is the fact that recently Bayless was the Wellness School District Award winner. I was maybe if you could give us a little background on what goes into this award, as well as what you've been doing at your school, obviously, to get this kind of recognition.
So basically, this is just a part of the overall direction our district has been moving to try and provide greater opportunities for our students and staff in terms of, you know, taking care of, you know, everybody more holistically. We're looking at, you know, in terms of social emotional, looking at, you know, physical health, dietary, you name it. We've been moving solidly in this direction for a number of years, and this is just the next piece. We're very excited to get it and the opportunities that it presents.
So one of the things that we were talking about is how you were able to get community buy-in. I was wondering if you could maybe unpack that piece for us.
So for a number of years here, our current superintendent, he's a change agent, and he wants to bring about as many opportunities, as I said, for our community, for our students. And so he has worked very, very hard to try and improve our facilities, our instruction, you name it. He has done a lot of very visible things, from updating our athletic facilities. We have a beautiful soccer and football complex, stadium that, you know, our students enjoy and now are able to, you know, have that moment of high school excitement or junior high excitement. We have a new baseball and softball facility. And then because of, I believe, these changes in the improved instruction and opportunities that their students are receiving, their kids are receiving, the community has really bought into what Bayless is selling. And as a result of that, it seems like we can't lose right now. We are doing great things for other people. That is our unofficial motto. And as a result of that, the community is supporting those moves that we're making.
And with that, talk to us a little bit more about the community, because I understand from talking to you earlier that there's somewhere between 25 to 28 different languages within the school district. Is that correct?
Yeah, it's an unbelievably diverse population that we serve. So our students do go home to a number of different languages. I think last time we looked, it is between 25 and 28. And so as a result, what's very cool about it is you have all these people from such diverse backgrounds. You know, they come in with all of these different experiences, different cultures, and it coalesces into a really wonderful educational community where we're all moving in the same direction. And again, regardless of the circumstance, we are presenting these wonderful opportunities for these people. And for them to buy into what we're selling, to get that many people to create a coalition of, right, you know, such a different groups of people is a pretty amazing thing. It tells us that we're doing something right.
So, Andrew, with that, why don't we talk a little bit about the COVID-19 challenges and how it's also certainly led to some professional development opportunities and the investment that you've been making into your teachers and staff?
So, as everyone has experienced, this has been an unbelievably challenging and unique year. And so, as a result of that, there's different things that come along with that. Our district as a whole has been placing a priority on supporting our students and staff to basically not only survive this time, but to come out stronger on the other end. And so we've been offering different PD opportunities, whether that's social emotional well-being, and it's stuff that you can use as a teacher for yourself, just for some self-care items, or if it's something that you want to apply within your classrooms to help your students, make them feel connected, because I think everyone's feeling a little disconnected as a result of Zoom meetings and what have you. But in addition to that, our PE staff, PE and health teachers, instructors, have stepped up in a big way, and they've led a number of PD sessions so that, you know, when you're getting a Zoom meeting after Zoom meeting, you also are being presented the opportunity to get a workout in and maybe take some stuff back that you can apply at home for some consistent wellness. And like I said, they stepped up in a big way, and those PD sessions are extremely well attended. People really look forward to them. They rave about them, and they really, again, I think they're getting a lot out of them.
Well, all I can say is that is a very, very exciting news. Anytime people can get, you know, really, you know, behind professional development, you know, you're making a great difference. And what I'd like to do, and during our research, I really have to be honest, this is one piece that I can't wait for you to comment on, because when I first read about it, I just was so excited, and know that for myself and my own personal life, this is something I've actually adopted. So why don't we introduce what the physical education program is doing there with this new thing called Ditch the Sugary Drinks campaign. So I was wondering if you could kind of camp on that for us.
So our PE teachers have recognized that, you know, this, everyone knows that sugary drinks are not doing anybody any good. And so, you know, in a nutshell, to simplify it, they've worked really hard to try and educate our students about, you know, some of the potential consequences of consuming sugary drinks. And I think the biggest piece of it is that education piece. Once you have the awareness, you can make an informed decision about, you know, what you choose to consume or not consume. So they're really pushing for that. There is a student-led component where a lot of the students are buying into this. They think it's a great idea. And then we're also looking at ways that we can restrict access, at least while the students are on campus, to these sugary drinks and replace them with healthier options that are going to, you know, be better for our students, probably our teachers as well. So,
well, I'm going to have to be honest with you, Andrew, that I can't wait to see or hear about how that program actually is received and some of the impact and results that may occur afterwards. So with that, before I ask you my final question coming up, I do want to ask you this. I asked this of a lot of our guests, but since COVID and all the challenges, as well as all the amazing things that have been going on, certainly at your school district with Bayless, how have you grown as a professional through this?
I think it in a number of ways. I think that it's caused me to be more adaptive, more flexible. It's caused me to look at things, you know, in different ways, not just at the surface value. And I think probably most importantly, it's caused me to adopt a more collaborative approach, because nothing is, you know, it seems like almost nothing is, you know, as you would expect it to be. It's not as easy as it first seems. So getting input from people on a lot of different levels, getting different perspectives, because I think this is a big problem that a lot of people have had to work to wrap their heads around. And as a result of that, we are adopting more unique approaches to things. We're becoming better at problem solving. And I think as a team, whether it's students, teachers, staff, administrators, we are all working together in this. And as I think a number of people have seen in their own life experiences, this year has caused people to lean on each other, and I think it's created a greater sense of community.
It totally has, and I can say this, you know, on behalf of our director at Missouri Healthy Schools, Laura Beckman, we say that all the time, that we believe the collaboration, especially within our field, is at an all-time high, as well as trying to coordinate so many different things, including our communications, like never before. So I thank you for sharing that, and it's just great when we can grow through this process as well and really learn, like you said before, to try new things and realize we're in unprecedented times. We continue to be in unprecedented times. With that, my final question is this, and I know that I always love coming back to this, and that is that piece of social emotional well-being. And I know that Bayless has made this a priority. As maybe if you could wrap up our broadcast and really kind of dig a little deeper into, you know, why and how Bayless has been going around making this a priority.
So we've had different sessions on how we can incorporate more social emotional well-being within everything that we're doing. So we're looking at ways that we can bring this to our teachers, ways that we can bring it to our students. We've led, as I said, PD sessions where we have Dr. Drew Schwartz, who's coming in and teaching 1-2-3 wellness to our teachers. Again, for themselves, these PD sessions have you reflecting on where you're at, what you need to do, just taking care of yourself, taking that moment. It's okay to take care of yourself and not focus on everybody else for just a minute, because if you're in a bad spot, there's no way that you can serve others. And then, you know, taking those same approaches and doing things from mindful moments, which we lead off the junior high's day with, where everybody takes some deep breaths. We have some inspirational quotes that students will share. And we're just looking for more ways that we can be more mindful about the mental health aspect and feeling okay with yourself.
Absolutely. And Andrew, I just want to thank you for taking the time today. As I learned an awful lot, I'm sure, as well as our audience. And all I can say is just want to keep wishing you and certainly, you know, your school district all the best moving forward as we get through the spring semester. And as we know, spring break's right around the corner.
Yes. So
I'm sure a lot of us are looking forward to that, because I know I am.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right. Well, here it is for Andrew Mertens. And again, we want to say congratulations to Bayless School District for winning or be given the award for the Worksite Wellness Award. And we want to thank you for watching here on Mo Health Media. And again, my name is Guy Danhoff, and we'll see you next week.